I had no idea that there was any precipitation today. Even forgot my beanie. It's all good. Day two of the 4-day stretch of work, so guys have a good one. Be careful. Make sure to breathe. Make sure to try to reflect on where we're blessed at. Not reflect on the negative. And even try to find a position where we have no thought. We're just in the now. I haven't started that book, but just in the moment, you know? Enjoying the conversation. And lending a listening ear, you know? I want to do better at that. I want to be a better listener. I know it's okay just to listen. And don't worry what the other person's underlying issues are or what defenses they have up. Because I know that's a big part of humans is even though we're talking, we have thoughts underneath words. So sit back and listen. You could even learn a lot more and observe. Can't really see the rain. Didn't think it was though.
Yeah. Who cares? Nobody cares, homie. Chase your dream. Yeah. Shout out Gonzo, Superman, show me love. Yeah. Who cares? Nobody cares, homie. Give a fuck what they think. Yeah. You only don't limit yourself, you know? This damn life is meaningless. Damn, fucking hate this shit.
Home Depot does collabs. That's right, Home Depot.
Gotta take a shit. Forgot it was Sunday. And we'll see.
It's a trip because at work, I come across so many different people, man. The other day I came across this dude. He had like a extra skin growing on his face, you know? It was like on the side of his face as a man. I don't know, I guess he couldn't afford surgery, or was he prolonging it, or did he not give a fuck? I don't know. He was this older dude, gentleman, but super cool, man. A super nice dude, man. And then another dude with his son. Like, the dad kind of had like a suspect voice. Like, he talked like with a lisp. Like, he kind of sounded like he was low-key gay, like soft. But his son was like my age, like, got like a little twist in his hair, like kind of like a Rico, not Rico Suave, but you know, a girl that guys would find, a guy that girls would find attractive, you know? So I didn't really, I was just being a dude, you know, trying to help him out. And then I finally looked at the dad, because like, I didn't want to make it seem like, I didn't want the son to feel off of me that I noticed his dad was kind of like soft or whatever. But he was just a nice guy, I guess, you know. But he also had like something on his face. There was another dude today, an older man. He had like these fake teeth. And like something in his face, I don't know, like something was wrong with him. Like, I don't know if he had any burns on his face, but he had like some acne on his face. But he had like these fucking new fake teeth. And so when he smiled, it was like a fucking cartoon smile. But he was super nice, man. Super cool. And like, he was like fresh. He had like a little, I don't know if it was platinum, but it was like a silver chain on. And I think he had some like wrist jewelry on. And he had like that old man smell. Like, he had like, he could smell his fragrance off of him, you know? But he was a super nice guy, you know? I try not to look at people and, you know, and judge them, you know? Like I said, I felt like I had deformities growing up because I was made fun of, you know? And you know, I see some other shit going on too, like some other crazy shit. I just run into so many different kind of people, man. It always makes me think like, damn, you know? There's other people struggling, you know, with their appearance, you know? Could be a messed up eye. There's a lot of people in this world with like a crooked eye, you know? And, yeah, I don't know, just, I see odd couples. But it was funny today. There was like this this dude, like his style, it was like a, I don't want to say rockabilly, but he had like an old hat. You know, like the hats I like to wear, like the old mailman hat. He had like a pretty cool hat. But he was with his mom and dad. He was like around my age, but you could tell he had good parents. And they wanted this mirror. This mirror's on sale. It's like a bathroom mirror. It's just a wall mirror. It doesn't open up or nothing, so you could probably use it in your room if you needed it. It's funny because that same mirror, I had told somebody that we didn't have it, you know, because it's on sale. People have been wanting it, but I actually found them on top. Well, that was today when this like I said, this son and his good parents, like a good, healthy, you know, Spanish-speaking parents. And it's Sunday, so I forgot. Maybe they all went to church together. I thought it was like a normal day. I was like thinking, like, what the fuck? The fool, you know? He has good-ass parents, you know? I guess he was just spending a Sunday with them. Like a good son raised by good parents would do, you know? And that tells a lot about the parenting, you know, that their kid wants to be around him. And, like I said, he had like one of those, I wouldn't say it was a nice flannel tee. He had like his pants cuffed up. I don't know what kind of shoes he had, but I thought the hat was dope. Like, man, I want to get a hat like that now. And, but it was funny because, I like told these people that, like, we don't have it no more, man. But then for some reason, I don't know if he works fucking, if he knows what the get down or whatever, but they weren't really like giving up too soon. So I just said, fuck, let me look. No, because what happened was, I don't know, I was trying to like, I don't know, I think he was trying to act like he knew what he was talking about. So I kind of like, I don't know, maybe I come off a little rough or aggressive, you know. It was kind of like, oh, he was thinking that, he was reading the boxes and stuff, you know, he was being assertive. Trying to, you know, go out of his way for his parents or whatever. And I told him, nah, man, we don't have it no more. Like, somebody came and the other day and we didn't have it. So I was like, fuck, man, I don't want to give up. So I actually found him. I was like, oh, I got him right here. I found him. And then, I don't know. It's like the unspoken thing. Like, sometimes there's a couple times where I've said, oh, we don't have it. And then somebody will find it. And they'll try to make me, like, not make me feel stupid. Yeah, they'll kind of try to make me feel stupid. Like, oh, here it is. It's right here. And then instead of like allowing them to like make me feel stupid, because that's what they're trying to do, I'll just be like, oh yeah, good job, man. Like, you know, I'll kind of be sarcastic back with them, because that's what people like to do. They like to make you feel stupid. And so anyway, when I found them, I didn't let that feeling arise, like me feeling stupid. I just kept moving and I got the ladder. I was being nice, you know. And that was like one instance, you know, the whole family. And I think I tripped them out. How I was still being confident within myself, like, okay, cool, we found them, you know, fuck it, cool. You know, I wasn't gonna let them try to make me feel stupid. And there was another time, I heard my coworker, she's really cool. She works, her name's Bonnie. She works in the paint. She's an older woman, but she also has like she has a fucked up eye. And low key, I don't know. I wanna ask her what happened to her, but I'm persistent in talking to her. Like, I always make sure, like, I don't give a fuck about your eye. I like our friendship. She's super cool. But I heard her saying, there's no plumber over there, I'll call one. I said, hey, Bonnie, don't call the plumber. And then I was like, who is it? Because he was a distance away. He was pretty much by the aisle that I was walking to go help him. And then sure enough, he was the same kind of customer. I thought so. Because I even told her, oh, is the customer just looking at me like that? Because a lot of customers, they like to just watch me look for shit. And they can't think for themselves, like, oh, shit. He doesn't know where it's at. He's looking, you know. Maybe I should help him look, you know. It's like, so anyway, the man asked for something. I told him, no, we don't have it. It's funny, that same day, another guy asked for the same shit. We had the part in a plastic piece, but he wanted it in metal. The other guy, but now I know we have it in metal. So I'd said it again, like, no, we don't have it. The guy came earlier and wanted to. There's so many fucking parts in that store, so I don't really care. I was busy anyway. And so, I don't really be sweated or beat myself up. Oh, I'm an idiot. I can't find a part, you know? Like, if I was a little kid, when I was younger, even fucking a couple years ago, I would have been, beating myself up for some stupid shit. I don't even give a fuck, you know? So just, wind off my shoulder, you know? So I, like, it's funny, because he, like he said, he couldn't fight it himself, but then when I was with him right there, I told him, no, we didn't have it. He was obviously there looking for it before he asked for help, and then he finds it, and then the nerve of the guy, he tries to be like, oh, like he, they put it in your face, like, so you, like, oh, here, I found it, oh, you didn't have it, you didn't have it? That's pretty much what they're trying to do. I'm like, oh, good job, and I just act like, I just kept going. Like, they want you to, people want you, humans are fucking stupid. They want you to feel stupid, like they're insecure. They wanted me to feel stupid. But I didn't let them, like, let them make me. I just kept acting cool, like, I just kept being normal, like, kept helping them, being nice, pretty much killing them with kindness, and, like, and then, other times, too, like, there was this guy with his girlfriend, and, like, you were animals, you know, I could tell when a girl probably takes a double look at me, even though she's with her man, like, okay, fuck it, let it be what it is, and, like, I don't know, like, sometimes when people chuckle in front of you, but you, like, I'm sure, like, when, like, even some people, like, they notice that their girl looks at me or whatever, and they'll ask me for help or something to, like, make it be like, yeah, know your place, you know, you're just a servant here, you know. I notice that sometimes, and also, like, I get myself prepared for, like, all right, don't have an attitude, don't let them try to see you frustrated or, like, bitter about your job, you know, like, I always try to do that, like, breathe, because they're gonna ask you, you know, he's gonna ask you for help to make it known that you're the fucking, you know, I'm pretty sure he has a good job, that's why he has that fucking attractive ass fucking lady, and, so I just tell me, all right, I check myself right away, because every time I see a customer coming when I'm busy, it's hard to get fucking do anything in that store. Like, is there, like, fuck, you can't get no rhythm. Like, hey, can you help me with this, or, you know? So a couple times that's happened. And but anyways, like, a guy chuckled today. Like, he kind of laughed, and I kind of like if I think deep about it, I'm like, he laughed, but he kind of laughed because he probably thought in his head to make himself feel better. Oh, he's just a Home Depot worker. I'm pretty sure he noticed. At my age, he noticed this lady fucking whatever. She just asked me for a part, you know? And it's just that natural human interaction, you know? It just happens. As humans, we have to fight that feeling, you know? When we look in the eyes, you know? We're sexual beings too, you know? And we're emotional. And so. But you just gotta counter everything people try to do to you. Just counter it. Counter it with your mind, you know? Empower your mind. Be prepared at all angles, you know? Be people by, and you can win. Tell people, hey, surrender. You can win. You got this. But just keeping that smile on your face, you know? People will always try to find a way to be better than you or make, or to overcome their insecurities by using you as a stepping stone. So yeah, it's pretty interesting, man. But know who you are, man. Know who you are. Know where you're going. It's the only way that you could feel good about yourself, secure. Peace.